For 6 months now, Minara Begum has lived in a near constant state of anxiety. She says going back to Myanmar is not an option.
My sister's family was burned to death. I don't know if anyone survived. I'm worried that fate awaits me and my family.
The Rohingya have faced discrimination and military crackdowns in Myanmar. Minara and her husband fled the country in 2011 on foot, leaving behind all their belongings. They paid an illegal broker to enter India and have rebuilt their lives here in New Delhi. India has no laws governing the status of refugees, but Minara and her family, like most Rohingya here, were issued long-term visas by the Indian government. They also hold ID cards given to them by the UN Refugee Agency. They say since the talk of deporting them started, the government has refused to renew their visas.
There are 48 families that live in this refugee camp in abject poverty. They build themselves these homes out of planks and bamboo. Most of the people here tell me that they have trouble finding employment, so they end up working either as day laborers or running small grocery shops, barely able to make ends meet.
Mohammed Salimullah is the man who challenged the government's deportation plan in India's highest court. He hopes the government will take the humanitarian way out.
This is not our country. We can't live here by force. We can only request the government to allow us to stay on like they have for many years now. We appeal to them for mercy. Take into account the violence that awaits us in Myanmar and don't send us back.
The government says the 40,000 Rohingya refugees living in India are vulnerable to being radicalized by terror groups and pose a security risk.
They have to go back, and that also equally applies to the Rohingyas who have got illegally settled in different parts of the country, including Jammu and Kashmir.
With the government refusing to budge, the fate of these refugees now lies with the Indian Supreme Court. Neha Poonia, TRT World, New Delhi.